yesterday won their semi. That's why they're in the centre late, and not beyond the realms of possibility they could catch the Croatians towards the end of this race. If they have a great row.
Murray and Bond dominated this event for so long. The world best time of 6.08.50 has stood since 2012. But perhaps we've got another dynasty about to be launched with the Sinkovic brothers, who go for Croatia in lane three, looking to make history in this Olympic rowing regatta. More of that in a moment. But this is a very strong field.
The stern of that Philippe Shell, the Italian manufactured boat. State boat person is just hanging on to, putting to the side. The plastic or perspex shoes or boots haven't sprung up from below the surface that hold the boat straight. Looks fairly flat on that little bit of the start. There it goes. Just pushing the bows of the boat into that perspex boot, we call them. Came into the sport of rowing from canoe and kayaking. Really handy in this cross tailwind to keep the boats aligned and straight so the oarsmen don't have to worry too much about the angle of their boat as it goes off the start.
So this is the second day of medals at the Tokyo 2020 Olympic Regatta. 6 gold medals awarded on day one. And we're going to see gold, silver and bronze here in the A final of the men's pair. An eagerly anticipated race. 6 boats in it. Kai Langefeld and Conlin McCabe. The last time a Canadian boat won a gold medal in this boat class, it was in Tokyo in 1964, George Hungerford and Roger Jackson. So Milos Vasic, it's his third Olympic Games. He was with Nenad Bedik in Rio. He's with Makovic now. Sinkovic and Sinkovic. The spectacular brothers from Croatia trying to write rowing history as the first crew to change disciplines and earn Euro, World and Olympic titles in 2 different boats. Cozmiuc and Tudosa want to take advantage of their momentum, having been quickest in the semi. Then come Vystavel and Sutton, outside shout in lane 5. In lane 6, the pair from Seville, Jaime Canalejo and Javier Garcia, who won the European Championship bronze for Spain in 2019 in Lucerne. So, all the build-up to the men's pair here in Tokyo. We were asking the question, are the Sinkovic brothers set to take over from Murray and Bond, the outgoing Olympic champions, the Kiwi pair who demolished the field in the first half of the decade just past, winning a London gold, following it up the defence of the title in Rio. It's the gold medal race at Tokyo 2020 in the men's pair. Canada in lane 1, Serbia in lane 2, Croatia, the Sinkovic brothers and the favourites in lane 3, Cozmiuc and Tudosa of Romania in 4, Denmark, Vystavel and Sutton in 5, and Spain, Canalejo and Garcia go in lane 6. We're going to ride there with the double sculls gold medalists from Rio. How impressive are these two?
Yeah, fantastic. They really do go out early doors. They will lead going through 500 metres. I think they'll lead going through the K and the 1500 metre mark. I think their Achilles heel is the last 500 metres. Yesterday it was 134.62 in the semi-final. The Romanians posted a 131.29. That's the jeopardy for the Croatians. And Vystavel and Sutton from Denmark in the foreground there gone out in second place. Canada a little bit more competitive off the start than they were in the semi. They just came through in the last moment. They're going over the boys on that right-hand side of the lake. They'll need to correct their steering to steer clear of them. But Condon McKay and Kai Lagerfeld have been rowing together for so long. The Canadian pair at the top of your picture. But it is the Croatians rowing beautifully at the moment. Really good rotation around the front end, well into their core muscles. Beautiful take at the front end.
500 metres then, and as perhaps expected, it's the Croatians. 1:31.89. That's 1.16 up on the Danes. The Croatians' first crew ever to go sub 6 minutes in the double. That was at the Amsterdam World Champs back in 2014. Very fast course, that wasn't it? 5:59.72. And then they just upped a gear in the double. They won the gold medal in Rio 2016. They're actually the quad, weren't they, in London? Got a silver medal for Croatia there. But since transferring into the pair, well, they bossed that as well. Back-to-back world champs in 2018 and 2019, and really pushing on now. A good, clear lead for Sinkovic and Sinkovic.
And interested on their splits, exactly the same split, 1:31.89, as they did through to the first mark in yesterday's semi-final. And I think they've moved out quite a lot now. If they can move out any more in the third quarter, that's going to be great for them. They do want to save something for the last part of the race. The Romanians, they're in bronze medal position at the moment, just behind the Danes, closest to us, Vystavel and Sutton. Both educated at American universities. Fred Vystavel at Princeton, Joachim Sutton at Cal Berkeley. And just improved race on race, the Danes there. There you see them. Don't slide the longest up to the front end, but they do get very dynamic, coached by Jens Willemsen.
Look at that, 0.02. That's all that separates Denmark and Romania. It's all about the battle for silver medal at present behind Sinkovic and Sinkovic. These brothers from Zagreb, Valent at 32, a year older than Martin. It's so impressive the way they've tweaked their skill set to dominate the pair from the double skulls. Vystavel and Sutton can't quite get at the Romanians. Cozmiuc and Tudosă, 28-year-old Cozmiuc, 4 years older than Tudosă, who was a youth Olympic champion in Nanjing in 2014, world under 23 silver medalist in the eight in 2017, works for the Ministry of Defence back home. Ciprian Tudosă, he'll be a real hero for Romania if he and Cozmiuc can get at the Croatians.
Which they are doing. They had a quicker third quarter yesterday. There was a little look round. Did you see it from Ciprian Tudosă? The 24-year-old strokeman, he's been rowing since he was 14 years of age. And they did have a quicker third quarter than the Croatians. And the gap has closed slightly. Well, the Croatians just trying to push out a little bit extra. They've just got that 50 centimetres or so of clear water between their stern and the bow of the Romanian boat. This is a big last quarter for the two Croatian brothers now, Martin and Valent Sinkovic. Got to stretch out, got to watch the Romanian sprint finish.
Into the last 500 then, as expected. Sinkovic and Sinkovic have been leading from the front in this men's pair final at the Tokyo 2020 Olympic Regatta. We do have little dynasties built in this discipline. Gin and Tomkins, and then Gin and Free for Australia. That was 04 and 08. Then Murray and Bond twice in London and Rio. But the Romanians are picking up with every stroke. There's going to be a battle for bronze as well, with Denmark coming under threat from Makovic and Vasic and Langerfeld and McKay for Serbia and Canada, respectively. The noise levels rise as we come towards the red boys, the last 250. It's still Croatia.
They've got it, the Croatians. The Romanians aren't going to get back from that. This is going to be a brilliant win for Croatia, barring crabs that we saw yesterday. Can't possibly see how the Romanians are going to sprint in that last 200 metres to get that margin on the Croatians. Denmark just holding on for the bronze medal. top of your picture, it's the Canadians charging like they did yesterday in the finish. McCabe and Langerfeld in for a medal, but here come the Croatians.
Yeah, Canada over there at the top of the picture, hunting down the Danes for bronze, but it's going to be a gold medal here for the world champions and the big race favourites in the men's pair. Over the line first, Croatia, the Sinkovic brothers. 5 years ago, it was the lightweight double. Now it's the pair, Romania and Denmark, just edge out the Canadians. So that one went to form. Sinkovic and Sinkovic are Olympic champions in the pair.
What celebrations. Martin kisses his wedding ring. And this is what they've trained for when they and their coach, Nicky Bralic, put their heads together, said, hey boys, do you fancy switching boat types, going to the pair? And that's what they did. Not sure the Danes know they've won the bronze medal yet. Yeah, there we go. From Joachim.
That's fantastic for Denmark. That's their first medal in this event since 1968. Peter Christiansen and Ib Larsen, who came in behind East Germany and the USA then, Cozmiuc and Tudosă. That's Romania's first medal in the men's pair since Seoul in 88. And that was a silver too, and a great finish just to hold off Canada for Denmark there.
Thumbs up to the Romanians there from the Sinkovic brothers. So well done to Cozmiuc and Tudosă. There's the reverse angle shot as the Croatians came through the 700-metre bridge.
And I suppose sometimes things pan out exactly as they were predestined to.
Yeah.
Well, it really was all about the second place in this one, wasn't it?
Yeah. Well, heroes, they're going to be back home in Croatia. I don't know what time of the night it is in Croatia. But there'll be a few bleary-eyed Croatians back in Zagreb, watching the replays of this race and celebrating now. That's what it means, double Olympic champions, just like Murray and Bond, but in different boat classes. They've gone one better, really, haven't they, than the Kiwis?
They've made history. They're the first crew to change disciplines and earn European, world and Olympic titles in two different boats, the Croatians. You just doff your cap to two very impressive individuals, Martin and Valent Sinkovic. And a good performance from the Romanians as well. Cozmiuc and Tudosă win the silver medal. Vystavel and Sutton for Denmark with the bronze.
Mesdames et messieurs, la cérémonie des vainqueurs de l'épreuve de deux de pointe sans barreur homme.
Ladies and gentlemen, the victory ceremony for the men's pair.
Minasama, tadaima yori dansu pair no hyousousuki wo okonaimasu.
Veuillez accueillir les médaillés.
Please welcome the medalists.
So, the medal ceremony then for the men's pair. It was a terrific race, that. The Sinkovics were favourites. They came in to win. And a spectacular bronze medal as well for Vystavel and Sutton. The Danish pair. So interesting medal ceremonies here at Tokyo 2020. Naturally, the sort of human contact is cut down a bit. All very spaced out, socially distanced, and the medals are presented to the rowers by themselves.
Les médailles seront remises par...
The medals will be presented by...
Whet the appetite for our medal races today in the men's pair.
His Royal Highness Prince Albert, the second of Monaco, himself an oarsman. Rows down in Monaco, the IOC member presenting the medals today.
Accompanied by...
And there's JC, World Rowing President, Olympic champion in the men's pairs from Sydney.
World Rowing President, France.
And still, at the age of, what is he, 49 or so, one of the fittest men on the course today.
Yep.
Every day on the world scene, he gets on the rowing ergometer, does his 16K.
Won that Sydney gold with Michel Andrieu 21 years ago. So, big applause for Vystavel and Sutton, first medalists in the men's pair since Mexico City in 1968, when Peter Christiansen and Ib Larsen got the bronze medal.
Yeah.
And a couple of bright lads here. Vystavel studying anthropology at Princeton University. Was at Eton for a bit as well, wasn't he?
I know, that's very unlikely, isn't it? How many Danish students are at Eton College?
And Joachim Sutton too, the 26-year-old. Bronze medals for Denmark in the men's pair. The Romanians were 24 hours after that spectacular win in the double sculls women. Another medal in this regatta, this Olympic rowing regatta for the Romanians. Silver in the men's four as well, wasn't it, for Romania? So third medal of Tokyo 2020, and it goes to Cozmiuc and Tudosă.
Yeah,
second in the men's pair.
The coach Antonio Colomalici is absolutely on fire here, hasn't he, with the Romanian men. I know their men's eight failed to qualify, but medals from the sweet medals from the men's pair and the men's four.
And the main men, the superb Sinkovic brothers, Martin and Valent, who've become the first crew to change disciplines and earn European, world and Olympic titles in two different boats.
Yeah, not forgetting the Canadian women did a feat similar back in 1992 and 1996, Marnie McBean and Kathleen Heddle.
Sinisa and Nixa Scalin won the silver in 2004, a pair of distinguished Croatian brothers, but these guys are the real deal. 5 years ago on the lagoon in Rio, it was gold in the double sculls. Now in Tokyo, it's gold in the men's pair for Martin and Valent Sinkovic of Croatia. So the medal winners in the men's pair, Martin and Valent Sinkovic of Croatia, Marius Cozmiuc and Ciprian Tudosă, and the Danes, Vystavel and Sutton.
for a few athletes that come out in the competitors' grandstand to support their countries and crews. Good for them sitting out in the open. It's quite hot here, but it does add to a bit of crowd noise.